Hello everyone. In previous part, we had learned about decision control statement. In this part, we will learn conditional operator and case control structures in C programming language. So, conditional operator means what? See, we know that if else statement, when we are using the if else statement, we need to write the series of a statement. Okay. And the main advantage of using the ternary operator, this conditional operator is ternary operator. We have covered this conditional operator in previous chapter, in chapter number 2 in C fundamentals, we learn about this. Okay. The main advantage of using ternary operator over if-else statement, because now we know that if-else statement and how to find the maximum between the two numbers by using the if-else statement. Maximum between the three numbers using the if else statement. But what is the advantage of this conditional operator over this if else statement? It reduces the number of line codes and improve the performance of the program. Okay, it will improve the performance of the application. Okay, and here is the syntax. This syntax is condition. If this condition is a true, then it will execute value is true. Okay, this first one part is. It will execute this part when your condition is true, and it will execute the next part of this column if the value is false. If this condition is false, then it will execute the part value is false. Okay. See, here is one example. Max equals to A greater than B means suppose A is greater than B. Here is we are using the condition. If yes, then execute A. Otherwise, it will execute the B part. Let's see the one example for this. See, write a C program to find out maximum between two numbers using ternary operator. Here we are using the ternary operator. So here are the variables are int a comma b. Okay, because we are trying to find out the maximum between these two numbers. So consider this number is a and b. And in max we will store the result. Okay, which number is greater? A is greater or b is greater? Okay. So next line is print enter the value of A and B. Okay, so read the value of A and B from the user. So scan a percent the address of A comma address of B. And here print f enter value of variable is A equals to percent D, B equals to percent D and A. Means first print the original value of A and B. Okay, enter value of A and B. And here is a we are using the conditional operator, ternary operator. And here is the syntax for this ternary operator. First condition, if this condition is true, it will execute this part. If this condition is false, it will execute only this part. So, maximum of A greater than B, see maximum equals to, why this maximum equals to? It will execute first the right side. So, if this A is greater than B, if the condition is true, it will store the A inside the maximum. If A is not greater than B, it will store the B into the max. And then you will get the output printf greater number is percent D max. Means so here you will get the output of the program. So let's run this program on online compiler. So copy this code and try to run on online compiler. So you can create the new file here. Okay, just click on a new file and you can create a new file. But sometimes you will get the error, so better practice to paste your code in main.c file only. Okay, you can run the any language program inside the this online compiler. But here I am using the C, only C compiler. So write the select here C and here you can write your code. So suppose this is your code. Just click on a run to run this code and check the output of your program. It's better practice to use the online compiler. You can use it on the mobile also. Okay. Enter the value of A and B. Suppose A's value is 56 and B's value is 33. And just press enter. So enter variables are A 56 and B 33. Greater number is 56. See, among this 56 and 33, 56 is a greater. So here you will get the output. Greater number is 56. Okay. It will check the value here. Here is a suppose our values are 56. Our values are the two values. So let's see. A is 56 and B is 33. So consider here 56 and here is the 33. And the 56 is greater, so it will be the 56 is greater. Okay. Now, next part of the session is case control statement, or you can say the switch case statement. Okay. Switch control or case control. Why case control? Because here we are using the different cases. See, you can see the decision making statement, but this is a multi-way decision making statement, because at the same time we are you can choose the any condition from the given. So this depends totally on the expression. If your expression matches to see this all things, all execution is depends on your expression. Okay, a switch statement is used to choose a statement from a group of statement. Okay, from a group of statement you can choose a statement among several alternatives. Among several alternatives you can choose the statement, depends on the expression. So if this expression is matches to the constant one, then you can execute the first case. If it is not matches with this, it will check where it matching, and depending on the matching it will execute the specific case. If the expression is not matched with the any of the case, then it will print the default. Okay, in default you can print the your user defined message as enter proper choice, or this choice is not correct. Okay, in such a you can print this message. And there are the some rules for writing these switch cases. Okay, this case is a, you see, we know that the C programming is a case sensitive. Okay, so you need to write the case all CASE in a small letters only. You need to write the colon after your constant. You can use the alphabetical constant, or you can use the here you can use the any integer number, but you can't use the other here. Okay, that is it can be an integer or character constant. You can use the constant as the integer or character constant. And the case label is, that is, the value must be unique. This constant or this case label must be unique. Don't do the two same name. Means here is the case one, and if there is a case next case also having the name case one, then there will be the confusion, and we will not get the correct output. And you need to specify the break. See, is it compulsory to specify the break? No. If you have not given the break inside your switch statement, then it will execute the first case also and second case. But when the break will occur in the switch statement, then it will automatically jump out from this switch statement. Okay. We don't use the use those expression to evaluate the switch case which may return the floating point value or string. Don't use this type of expression. Okay, so use the integer value or character constant as an expression. So let's see the one example for this case control. So this is the one example for case control. See, here we are trying. See, when we are using the switch case in our program, at this time the most of the time the program name is minute-driven program. Means here we are using the different menus. And how to select the particular menu? Depending on the case, depending on the matches, expression, we are executing the particular case. See, this program is minute-driven program to perform the arithmetic operators. Arithmetic operators. See, int a, comma b, comma ch. There is a different period. Then enter the value of a and b. So enter the value of a, enter the value of b. These are the two values. Then print f. This is our menu. Addition. First is addition. Means, see, we know that we know the switchboard. If you want to start the fan, then just press the one button, so fan will on. But if you don't know about this switchboard, कैसे चालू होगा? Suppose आप new जगह है, कौन सी भी नई जगह है, वहाँ पे गए, आपको बोला है कि फैन चालू करो. You don't have any idea. Okay, number which button for the fan, for the tube light. Then how to press? So at that time आप क्या करते हो? सब बटन चालू करके देखते हो. Okay, so तो उसके बाद फैन लेते हो. अगर आप वहाँ पे लेबलिंग करते हो कि F for the fan, T for the tube light, T1, T2, तो आपको इजी रहेगा. सिमिलरली हियर वी आर यूजिंग द स्विच केस इन दैट वन इज एडिशन. मीन्स सपोज इफ यू वांट टू ऐड अ टू नंबर, देन जस्ट सी, दिस इज अ मैसेज फॉर द यूजर, फर्स्ट एडिशन टू सब्ट्रैक्शन. सी, ये जो अभी स्विच केस का है, फर्स्ट एडिशन सेकेंड सब्ट्रैक्शन, आप जब भी मोबाइल यूज करते हो आपको बैलेंस चेक करना है. तो कंपनी का मैसेज आता है कि फॉर डिटेल इन्फॉर्मेशन प्रेस दी वन, फॉर द बैलेंस प्रेस द टू, फॉर द ऑफर्स प्रेस द थ्री. सो आप जब थ्री प्रेस करते हैं तो उसके बाद उसका डिटेल आता है. सो वहां पे भी कुछ तो स्विच केस यूज किया है. Similarly here, addition, subtraction, multiplication, enter your choice. What you need to do from this, suppose I want to subtract the two numbers, select the choice is 2. Okay, so scan if %H means what? From this we are selecting the choice as an integer number 2, so scan if %CH, switch CH, so this 2 will match it. Okay, so we will send this 2, this CH. From here, so switch CH. So वो जो भी हम यहाँ पे choice में जो भी data type दिया है, जो भी values दिए, वो हम match करने वाले हैं. This addition to case 1, subtraction to case 2, 3 to 3 multiplication to this multiplication case. Okay, in this one. Okay, so switch CH, pass this value from this CH. Suppose the value is 1, it will match as this 1 to the case 1. Then it will add this number, addition of percent and percent. Why I have given this type means addition of 5 and 6 equals to 11. I want this type of output 9. So addition of percent means the value of A will put here and then value of B is assigned to this second one percent and you will get the output as 11 after this break. If user using the second choice, user placing the number as a 2, then case 2 will execute, then subtraction of two numbers, okay, A, B, and here A, B, A minus B is the operation. You can write it on a next line also. You can first add or subtract the number, and on the next line you can print it out, okay, or you can write it in a single line, no problem, okay. Next, case 3 is for the multiplication, then multiplication of two numbers, A and B. We are using the two numbers, A and B, and here is the multiplication of two numbers. Case 4, printf, division of percent D and percent D equals to percent F. Okay, so here, see here is some extra brackets and float keyword. Okay, why I have written this float here? Because when you are adding the or dividing the two integer numbers, then maybe there is a division in a floating point number. So here you need to specify the float in bracket. This is known as a type casting of variables. Okay, here we are changing the type of this answer, means A divided by B. Means suppose you have taken the first number as a 5 and second number as a 3, and then there is the answer is in a decimal place. So I have written here float, okay, and then break. And default means you have given the 4 choice to the user, but in some cases, user by mistakenly or forcefully they are placing the choice as a 5 or 10 or the 11. Then at that time, you need to give the message to this user, printf, enter proper choice. So when a user press entering the choice in between the 1 to 4, then only he or she will get the output. Okay, and then after this, return 0. Okay. Let's try to execute this program on online compiler. For this we will use our online compiler. So copy this program, or you can directly type all this whole program in online GD. Okay, so press the program here and just click on run to run this code. See, this is the program. See, by default here is the one dotted line. It will show this which is open from here and you have closed here. Then next one bracket is case 1, then case 2, case 3, case 4. These are the different cases. Okay, see here is the output line, enter the value of A and B. When you are using the Turbo C or the Linux operating system, on that you will get the new window, and on the new window you need to enter the input for this value. Okay. When we are using the Turbo C, on a console, you will get this. Console means from here we are entering the input. Enter the value of A and B. Suppose A's value is 6. Okay. Suppose here A's value is some value is for the A. Suppose 2 is a value and next value is a 7. So these are the two values for A and B. And this is a menu. This is a menu driven program. addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. So enter your choice. Suppose my choice is a 2, then press enter. So subtraction of 2 and 7 is equals to minus 5. Okay, in this way you can try for the other choice also. Just click on a run. So and then again we will check for, suppose this is number 77 and 7 and 3. Just press enter. Okay, enter your choice. I know that first is addition, 2 is a subtraction, 3 is a multiplication and 4 is division. But mistakenly I have pressed, I'm pressing this 8. So what will be our output? Let's check. So output is enter proper choice, because this 8 is not in this case. Okay, so it will give you, because here you have mentioned the default. So default is also necessary in switch case. Because when you are not using this default in a switch case, at that time it will not give me any answer. It will create a confusion. So it's better in the practice to choose the default in switch case. Default is a keyword. Okay. And this is all about the conditional operator and switch case in C programming. In this part, we learn the conditional operator and example of this, and the case control switch case statement. Thank you.